This is Christ Liveth Sprague Apostolic Ministry, Clown, where the power of God works miracles through the hands of the anointed man of God, Pastor Wole Oladimi, the senior pastor, as he ministers salvation, deliverance, and healing. Prayers, they say, is the master key, but you must pray with understanding through the word of God and the reality of your new creation to defeat the enemies of your soul. Your life will not remain the same as you listen to this life-changing message. Thank you and remain blessed.
Shall we put our two hands unto the Lord, lift our two hands unto the Lord and shout seven loud hallelujah. Shall we go?
Hallelujah! 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 Hallelujah!
I have no other God but you. I have no other God but you. What about you?
I have no other God but you.
Lift up your hands unto him and tell him,
I have no other God but you.
He will do,
he will do what no man can do.
He will do,
he will do what no man.
No!
You will give what no man can give.
You will give what no man can give.
You better raise up your hand and receive from him.
You will give what no man.
One more time.
Hey, you will give.
You will give what no man can give.
You will give.
You will give what no man can give.
I have no.
I have no other God but you.
I have no.
Talk to God this morning. Tell him you don't have any other God. Just like that young man has testified. They asked him to take other options. He said, no, I have no other God but the living God. I will rather stick with him. And the Lord got him the visa. Tell him you don't have any other God. On one condition, should you keep quiet if you have any other God? But if you don't have any other God, then present that case before him. Tell him you don't have any other God. Lord, do only what you can do for me on this matter. Because you have done what no man can do. And you will do what no man can do. You will give me what no man can give me. Tell God, this is the time to talk to God. God is taking us somewhere this morning. From your heart, make a presentation unto him. Has God promised you something? and it seems as if age is weighing on you, and you are saying, where will it happen? Tell him. You cling unto him tenaciously. I have no other God but you. Numbers 23 verse 19. God is not a man that he should lie, neither the son of man that he should repent. Has he said, will he not do it? Has he spoken, will he not make it good? Tell him, I believe you, Lord. You are going to do it for me. Talk to him. Talk to him. Talk to him. Tell him you have faith in him. This is the time to challenge God on that matter. Can someone challenge God this morning? Lord, I stand on your word. I have faith in you. Tell him, I have no other God who can fix it. If you can't pay this bill, nobody can pay it. If you can't do it, nobody can do it. You did it for that man by the bull of Bethesda for 38 years. You will do it for me today. Oh yes, the daughter of Abraham for 12 years. The woman with the issue of blood for 18 years. You did it for Mephibosheth. Begin to recount the miracles that you have known about God. You brought Mephibosheth out of Lodebar. You did it for Hannah. Oh yes. You did it for Zechariah and Elizabeth. You will do it for me. You did it for the man by the beautiful gate. Tell him, I have no other God. I have no other God. I am not going to follow any other God. Any man made God, you will do it for me. I believe in your word in Psalm 33 verse 9. For God spoke and it was done. I believe in that word. He commanded and he stood fast. Challenge him by the authority in his word. Challenge him, challenge him. Isaiah 30, 21. Tell him you believe in him. Present the case of that your child before the Lord. Present the case of your husband before the Lord. Present the case of your wife before the Lord. Present your business case before the Lord. Your ears shall hear a word behind you saying, this is the way, walk in it, when you turn to the right and when you turn to the left. Ask God for direction this morning. This is the session that someone is receiving a major miracle. Igbagbo mi duro lori eje atondodo Jesu. Ko je gbeke lohun kan lehin oruko la Jesu. Mo duro le Christ abata. Ile mi ra. Iya ri ni ya ri lo je mo duro le Christ abata. Aye raye ile mi ra. Baba o iya ri. Talk to God this morning. Cry to God. Bire ije mi tinegun. Oro fere. Ko yi pada. Bo ti wu ki jina leto. Idakoro. Mi ko niye. Moduro le. Krisapata. I want you to cry to him this morning. Tell him. Challenge him by his name. Jehovah Nisi, Jehovah Rapha, Jehovah Shalom. Talk to God. This is the time to talk to God. Tell him you believe in him. Oh yes, talk to him.
Majemu ati ejere lemi oromo bikumide batiko sati leima oje ire ti lafumi modurone modurone Krista bata ile mi ro. Loje mo duro le Krista bata aye aye ile mi ro
greater God than him. Cry to God. Ask him to come speedily to help you. Can someone tell God this morning, God, have mercy on me. I don't know what to do again. Can you shout the cry of mercy? Oluwa shanu for me. Lord, I am getting tired. Have mercy on me, oh Lord. I know, I believe Philippians 4:13. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Lord, come and strengthen me this day. Talk to God. Talk to God. Pa Olorun soro.
Ati pe kehin ba si du. Ambale wa ninu Jesu. Woro do do reni ko. Induro ne ne wajo ita moduro ne moduro ne Krista panta ila miro niyari niyari loje moduro ne Krista panta ayera ye ila miro baba o niyari o moduro ne moduro ne Krista panta.
And so Jehovah, we salute your majesty this glorious morning, this day that you have made that we should rejoice and be glad in it. We thank you for the various testimonies that you have sent our way. Thank you for what you are doing in our nation, Nigeria. Thank you because Nigeria will survive marvelously. Thank you because of your hands that are very mighty upon every one of us. Thank you for this mountain, for various testimonies. Take all the glory in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I decree unto everyone that this month shall be your month of comfort.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The name of the Lord shall be glorified.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Put your hands together for the Lord and be seated. God bless you. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen.
Good morning, sir.
I want to bless the name of the Lord for this meeting this morning. We thank God for the various testimonies that we have heard. Now, beginning from the testimony of that young man, he said his father, when he was just exactly in his age bracket, suffered four misses. But because God has ordered his step to this mountain, he said, the battles that fought my father will not fight me. Lo and behold, despite all those suggestions from Babylon, he said, I am a man of Zion. I cannot sing the Lord's song in a strange land. I will rather stick unto God. And I know the God I'm serving on this mountain. During the 21 days prayer and fasting, he said he brought his passport on the honor that the Lord gave through me, that bring your genuine documents. Lo and behold, from the beginning, even when he did not know what to say, the interviewer was teaching him what to say. When God wants to settle you, every protocol will be broken. And the Lord broke protocol for him. Now he's on his way to America to be a world-class star. Watch out, within 3 years, his name shall be heard all over the world. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
So I pray for someone this morning, the God who broke protocol for him, let him break protocol for you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The Lord who broke protocol for that young man shall break protocol for you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And the second one, that the battles that fought, or that the battles that are fighting your parents, or that fought them, Ogun to ba won baba nla yin ja. Everyone, wherever you may be, whether you are white, Caucasian, or black, I want to let him in. The same battle will not fight you.
Amen. You didn't say amen very well.
Amen.
I said the battles that fought your parents to the ground will not fight you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Well, maybe you will say amen when you see Ezekiel 16:44. You know, when prayers are coming, I have taught you and I have told you, make sure you grab every prayer with your amen, whether it's for you or not. When any case is called, just make sure you pray. Ezekiel 16:44. Look at it, everyone. Ezekiel 16:44 says, behold, everyone that uses proverbs shall use this proverb against thee. Don't say amen. Say, as is the mother, so is the daughter. As is the father, so is the son. As is the mother, so is the son. As is the mother, so is her daughter. Any battle that may want to transfer into your life through your parents, within the loud amen, let the blood of Jesus scatter that battle in the name of Jesus.
Amen. 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 Jesus.
Settle. The battle that fought them that didn't make them to make a headway in life. You should say amen. You are being funky for
them.
The battle that ravaged your parents. Not making them to make it in life. With one loud amen. That battle will not fight you again. In the name of Jesus. Will not fight you again. Will not fight you again. Hear this and hear very well. Any parental evil pattern. Any evil family pattern. Ravaging you, your siblings, your cousins. Today, by the finished work of Calvary, let the Lord break that pattern. In the name of Jesus. Let the Lord break that pattern. In the name of Jesus. I want to pray this prayer.
Perfect God, who are you?
The battles that jumped into your lives from your parents. Now, by the power and in the blood of Jesus, let those battles disappear now. In the name of Jesus, let them disappear now. Let them disappear now. In the name of Jesus, the records that your parents could not break. Now, wherever you are, with a very loud amen, receive the grace of God to break that record. The line they were unable to cross. Now, wherever you may be, receive the grace of God to cross that line. Good things in life they could not do. Ladies and gentlemen, I want a very loud amen. Receive the grace of God to beat that record. The height they could not reach. Receive the grace of God to exceed that height. To exceed that height. In the name of Jesus. If your hands can be taller than your head, the same way, the level that your parents reached, you will go higher in the name of Jesus. 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 The age that they retired your parents into redundancy. That shall be the beginning of your achievement in the name of Jesus. Your lives will not go the lives of your parents. In the name of Jesus. Even if they have done well, you will exceed their record. In the name of Jesus. It shall be well with you. In the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Say a big amen. Be seated. God bless you. Now, this morning, I want to give a warning. What you are going to hear from the Lord is exclusively prepared for you.
Oni Olorun ti seto sile fun onikan.
So don't be distracted.
Ma je ki okan ro sakolo.
Ensure you release your faith to receive every word.
You ri pe oni igbagbo lati gba gbogbo re.
Hear this.
Egbo eleyi.
This is our month of comfort.
Aosu itura wa niyi.
Comfort means ease.
Itunu.
Rest.
Alafia.
Wellness.
Isimi.
Peace.
Dada alafia.
Relaxation.
Keki ariwa alafia.
I pray for everyone. I just want a very loud amen. In any area that you are experiencing any pain, let the God of comfort visit you in the name of Jesus. The Lord will comfort you in the name of Jesus. Those of you who have received your first testimony this year, God will add to that testimony in the name of Jesus. Those of you who have not received your testimony, within the next 24 hours, in the name of Jesus, let your testimonies begin. In the name of Jesus. Let me quickly deliver this message. I had the name Yinka. Your time has come. I just had
her.
Even if I don't bear that name, I will claim it. Your time has come. Your time has come. Your time has come. Your time has come. In the name of
Jesus.
There is someone going through what you don't understand. The Lord is saying he wants to bestow upon you today the spirit of understanding so that you can know what to do. Wherever you may be, receive the spirit of understanding.
Yeah.
In the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
There is a lady here. And I want the lady, even if you are in plot 4, you must run to the altar here. You normally see yourself as a housemaid. No matter what you do in life, nothing works. Where are you? Be on your knees. You, anytime you dream, you see yourself as an
animal.
I pray that spirit of slavery, that spirit of slavery, let it depart from your destiny in the name of Jesus. Let it depart in the name of Jesus. Let it depart in the name of Jesus. Let it depart in the name of Jesus. Everyone, whether you are a man or a woman, young or old, if they normally enslave you in your dream, they normally give you work to do and they enslave you, they enslave you in the dream. Every dream of enslavement you have ever had, I want a very loud amen. Let the blood of Jesus wipe it off. 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 In the name of
Jesus.
Hear this. Every downgrading spirit programmed into your destiny. Every downgrading spirit programmed into your destiny. With one loud amen, let that spirit disappear in the name of Jesus. 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 May I request this man, who is a victim of inadequacy, despite the fact that you are heavily loaded, but the spirit of inadequacy is troubling you. When I say this prayer, you must say amen more than anybody. That spirit of inadequacy, let him live your life in your name, Jesus. Let him live your life now. 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 In the name of Jesus. Efforts to renew your battles and problems through dreams.
They want to be renew your problems to dreams. Ladies and gentlemen, I come as a prophet of God to decree all the efforts made to renew your problems to dreams. Let the efforts be aborted in the name of Jesus. 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 Lord wants me to pray. That's from today. Not tomorrow. As from this moment. The heavens upon you. Open in the name of Jesus. Open in the name of Jesus. That pain in your chest and your breast. That peppery sensation in your breast. In your armpits. In your shoulder. That sharp pain in your shoulder. Right now, in the name of Jesus, be evacuated by fire. Be evacuated by fire. Be evacuated by fire. In the name of Jesus. There is a man here. Anger is what is not making you to progress. Whether you are a man or a woman, I want you to say amen. Every spirit of anger and bad temper, let it get out of your life in the name of Jesus. Let it get out. In Jesus' name, I prophesy.
Amen. In
Jesus'
name.
Go back to your seat. Thank you. Now listen to this very carefully, Blair. The Lord dictated every word to me this morning. So when I was giving his testimony, I gave my note to one of my ministers to check. Nahum chapter 1 verse 9.
Nahum 1:9.
Nahum
1:9.
What do you imagine against the Lord? Listen very carefully, please. He will make an utter end. Amen. Affliction will not rise up the second time.
Amen.
Now hear this. The Lord said to me,
Oluwa so fun mi.
Says, son,
ara omo mi,
go and release a curse.
Lord gegun
against affliction of losses.
Lori lodi si awon kan ju amuba.
Cause the affliction of losses.
Bi awon
amuba. Very many people are suffering from losses.
Opolopo ni o ni ogun amuba.
And the Lord said to me,
Oluwa so fun mi,
there are three women that will be in this meeting suffering from losses in the area of pregnancy.
Pe awon obirin meta wa ni bi to je pe oyun ma wale lara won.
And he said, when these prayers are going on,
where
they are, they must just kneel down. And the Lord said I should give to them Exodus 23 verse 26. The Lord said he wants to heal a very chronic barrenness today. And he wants to give back to people what they have never imagined they can get this year. Now, Exodus 23, verse 26, there shall nothing cast their young nor be barren in the land. The number of their deaths they shall fulfill. So, everyone who is losing pregnancy, today, wherever you may be all over the world, you will not lose pregnancy again in the name of Jesus. That dream you normally dream, that occurrence that triggers the loss, today marks the end in the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
That affliction will not rise up the second time. Yeah. Will not rise up the second time.
Yeah.
In the name of Jesus. Yeah. Now hear this. Are you suffering from repeated afflictions? Especially in the area of losses. The Lord wants me to say this. Number one. No more losses. In the name of Jesus. If you like, say amen. If you like, don't say amen. No more losses. In the name of Jesus. Power behind losses in your life shall be arrested today. In the name of Jesus. Strange altars causing losses shall be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Losses through dreams must stop today in the name of Jesus. The losses you have stopped, you have suffered through carelessness, shall stop today in the name of Jesus. Now hear this and say big amen. You will not lose opportunities again in the name of Jesus. you will not lose your chances again in the name of Jesus. You will not lose pregnancy again in the name of Jesus. You will not lose your peace again in the name of Jesus. Circumstances leading to losses will not rise up again. In the name of Jesus. Just hear this and hear very well. Joel 2:25. Joel 2:25 says, I will restore to you the years that the locust had eaten, the cacaworm, the caterpillar, and the palmer worm, my great army which I will send among you. The Lord is asking me to prophesy. And when the prophecies are going on, please receive them. In the name of Jesus, everyone under the sound of God through me, recover your lost years. In the name of Jesus. All those years you have lost, recover them. Recover them. In the name of Jesus. Number two, your lost ideas. Recover them in the name of Jesus.
Recover.
Your rewards that you have lost, recover them in the name of Jesus.
Recover.
Your lost virtues, recover them in the name of Jesus.
Recover them.
Your exchanged virtues, recover them in the name of Jesus.
Recover them.
If I were to be you, I will say the loudest amen to this. Your stolen virtues, recover them in the name of Jesus.
Recover them.
Your lost joy, recover it in the name of Jesus.
Amen. Recover them.
Your lost positions, recover them in the name of Jesus.
Amen. Recover them.
Your lost marital romance, recover it in the name of Jesus.
Amen. Recover them.
Sit down, please. At exactly 5:03, the Lord said to me, son, go to 2 Kings chapter 8 and read the first 6 verses. There is someone I want to pray for you. In the environment where you are living, there is a terrible opposition. In fact, the opposition is so great that nothing in your hand survives there. They don't want good things to survive. They don't want establishment in that place. The people there, it seems as if hell gathered them together and planted them in that environment. And they are not making what you are doing to do well. Don't say the Lord. In Isaiah chapter 54, Isaiah 54, verse 15. Behold, they shall surely gather together, but not by me. Whosoever shall gather together against thee shall fall for your sake. The first prayer is that every opposition against you in that environment shall scatter in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
If I were to be you, I would say the loudest amen to that.
Amen.
That opposition shall scatter in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Shall scatter in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Those who gather together saying your work will not survive there, according to Isaiah 54:15, let them fall for your sake.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Some people, they have said they are the ardent enemies of clam. And the Lord is saying they will be falling, will be rising.
Amen.
I decree in the name of those who are saying that environmentally they will continue to attack you and your work and your family, let them fall for your sake in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Every opposition against you, where you are to make it, let that opposition scatter.
Amen.
Let it scatter.
Amen.
Let it scatter. 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 In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Sit down. There is someone here at exactly 5:27 a.m. I heard twice. I, God, will establish you this year.
Amen.
If you are the best, can I hear a louder amen?
Amen.
God, we establish you this year.
Amen.
God, we establish you this year.
Amen.
You are not saying a big amen.
Amen.
God, we establish you this year.
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 Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Say another Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. your son is tired of education for no reason, he said, I don't want to study again. It's because that son was attacked and the Lord said I should pray. You, that boy, wherever you may be, that spiritual tiredness making you to hate education, right now, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, and for those who will stand in the gap for their children, let the Lord remove that spiritual tiredness.
Amen. In the name of Jesus.
Amen. Now I make a decree in the name of Jesus, you, that child, be delivered in the name of Jesus.
Be delivered, 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 be delivered.
In the name of Jesus.
Now, 2 Kings 8, 1 to 6. Please, I read. Listen very carefully. Then spake Elisha unto the woman whose son he had restored to life, saying, arise and go thou and thy household and sojourn wheresoever thou canst sojourn. For the Lord has called for a famine, and it shall also come upon the land for 7 years. Number 2. And the woman arose and did after the saying of the man of God, and she went with her household and sojourned in the land of the Philistines 7 years. And it came to pass at the 7 years end, 7 years end, 7 years end, the 7 years end of that your problem terminates today in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
7 years, God terminates it in the name of Jesus. Today, God terminates it.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Any problem that's 7 years old, today marks the end of the 7 years old problem.
Amen.
Can I hear a louder amen? Can I hear another amen? And it came to pass at the 7 years end that the woman returned out of the land of the Philistine, and she went forth to cry unto the king for her house and for her land. And the king talked with Gehazi, the servant of the man of God, saying, tell me, I pray thee, all the great things that Elijah has done. Verse 5. And it came to pass, as he was telling the king how he has restored a dead body to life, that behold, the woman whose son he had restored back to life cried to the king for her house and for her land. And Gehazi said, my lord, O king, this is the woman, and this is her son, whom Elijah had restored to back to life. And when the king asked the woman, she told him. So the king appointed unto her certain officer. That officer for you is an angel. Saying, restore.
Amen.
All that was hers, restore.
Amen.
All that was hers.
Amen.
And all the fruit of the field, since the day she left the land, even until now. Sit down. See now, don't interpret. The Lord said to me, there is always a freedom, a release at the 7 years end of a particular affliction. And at the terminal end of 7 years end, when that affliction wants to repeat again, God stops it and banishes it forever. I decree that 7 years ending of that problem. Now, vamoosis today in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
When the woman came, there was a discussion, please sit down, between the king and Gehazi, the servant of Elisha. Tell me, I pray thee, please talk to me. I want to know the great things that Elisha has done. And the Lord said to me that he wants to make some arrangement today. Today. I don't know when you are watching this teaching, when you are listening. And the Lord said that, tell the people I can make an arrangement for someone to just find out about them. In order for their restoration, reward, and recovery to come, and repositioning, 4 things.
Amen.
Number 1, that reward can be given back to someone, restoration can be brought back to someone,
Recovery can be delivered to someone. Repositioning can be given to you when God makes an arrangement for a noble to find out about you, your organization, your work, your write-up, what you have done in the time past, something you have said somewhere, something good that you have done. He will just make that arrangement for them, for somebody in the top place to just find out about you. And immediately, there will be the following things. Number one, the Lord said there is someone that this is how your own restoration will come. One, you will be highly recommended by the noble. Two, you will be favorably recommended in the name of Jesus. Then when the noble makes an inquiry about you, they will look for you in a hurry. They didn't hear me. They will look for you in a hurry. To give you your reward,
amen.
Your restoration,
amen.
Your recovery,
amen.
Your repositioning.
Amen.
You didn't hear. The Lord is saying that when they said, okay, tell me something about this woman. Tell me something about this man. I've had this. Okay, let's just check. They just run through the net. They want to headhunt. They just do a background checkup. Then your name pops up and they see things about you. I said, okay, let's look for this person in a hurry. I want to pray it into the destiny of someone. And if you are standing in the gap for your children, you better say amen. When they check about you, somebody will recommend you favorably.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
They will look for you in a hurry.
Amen.
You know, you have been doing all this thing about Nigeria. You post it online. You do this. You do that. Over the years. Somebody will say, who is this woman doing this? Then they share, they say, she has started almost 20 years ago. This is the time to look for her. And they begin to look for you. Sir, I anoint you right now by the power of the Most High God. The anointing of God for people to check all over the world what you have done in the time past and for you to be located and for you to be recommended favorably and for them to look for you in a hurry. Receive the oil in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I say receive it now.
Amen.
Receive it now.
Amen.
Receive it now.
Amen.
Receive it now.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Sit down. You see, the Lord said to me, tell the people, when they make inquiries about you, about your NGO, about your articles, about your message, about your prowess, about your dexterity, about your knowledge, about your know-how, about something written about you, about your organization, about your profile, about what you are doing or what you have done and you have forgotten, about where you have worked when you were young. The Lord is saying that all your past efforts unrewarded shall be rewarded in the name of Jesus. Shall be rewarded in the name of Jesus. Your good work done and forgotten shall be seen. They will ask for you. They will look for you. In the name of Jesus. Now they may see what you have done. They will say, who built this house? Who painted this place? Who did this work? Who had done this? Go and bring this person for a repeat performance. I don't know who is receiving that this morning, whatever you may be all over the world. They will see one thing you have done and they will ask you to be brought in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Can I hear a loud amen? You shall be brought.
Amen.
You shall be brought.
Amen.
You shall be brought.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
When they are headhunting, miraculously, your name will pop up.
Amen.
Now, in the dream, in the vision, let God show you to your helpers.
Amen.
To organizations.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let the Lord reveal your work in the realm of the spirit to those who will bless you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Say, I receive it.
I receive it.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of
say
Jesus.
A big amen.
Amen.
And in verse 6, sit down. Say, restore all that was hers. And the Lord said, I should tell someone, all that is yours shall be restored.
Amen.
That amen was too weak.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Isaiah 42 verse 22. Isaiah 42 22. But this is a people robbed, spoiled. They are all snared in holes. And they are hidden in prison houses. And they are for a prey and none delivered. For a spoil and none said restore.
I have the mandate of the Almighty God this day to speak into your destinies in any area that you must be restored. Now be restored in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Be restored in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Be restored in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Say a big amen.
Amen.
Now, hear this. God said to me that he wants to go deep today to really release people into restoration,
amen,
recovery, reward, and reposition.
Amen.
Matthew 3:10. Matthew 3:10. And now, also the axe is laid unto the root of the trees. Therefore, every tree that has swallowed your benefits. Any tree where they are doing meetings, say you will not be restored. any village tree. Saying that you will not be restored. Shall be consumed by fire in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Now, before I go on, look at this clip, everybody. Then we start prayers. Sit down. Give it volume, please. Can you see a tree? Can you see a bulldozer? Can you see the bulldozer trying to pull down the tree? This is not a film, it happened in real life. Can you see the bulldozer trying to uproot it? Eh? Look at it, look at it, look at it. Oh, that's scene one. I will see whether you will pray or not. Breaking the taproot. That's scene two. Wash it very well. It stood up the third time. The Lord said to me that there are wicked villages and towns where there are evil trees. Though you were born in London, in America, you were born in Yugoslavia, even Afghanistan. But in the realm of the spirit, you are connected to your root. The Lord said to me, many wicked ancient trees are not making people to be restored, making them to recover. That happened in Volta region in Ghana. All of a sudden, they saw something, some things shining on the tree, and they heard noises. By the time they got there, they couldn't see anyone. They brought the bulldozer to pull it down. The tree stood up four times, and the people engaged prayer warriors. And at last, after some days, the tree fell. And it was discovered by one of those witches who confessed that that is where they package people's benefits. That tree you saw had many doors. In my hometown, we have been praying to the Almighty God for 23 years. There was this ancient tree there that when we started crusade, because when we were moving around the town prophesying onto the land, the car where I was
with the intercessors, broke down by the tree because of overheating. They surrounded the vehicle while we escaped, and they said, I wanted to call the tree. I was arrested in the night, physically. They brought out occultic knives to remove my two eyeballs. That was in 1993. And I stood up. I said, if God has sent the Christians here, and we are championing the kingdom, that your tree will give up, and every idolatry in this town, and Jesus will stand. And they said, we will not last that year. And I told them, the battle line is drawn. Before the end of the year, they started committing suicide, the occultic people, while we are still alive. They sent to us to beg so that they wouldn't die. I said, no, Jesus had drawn the line. But today, without the Christians in that town, they can't survive. But last year, that major tree, a light wind just blew, uprooted it, and the thing fell, and at the center of the earth, they saw one sharp knife that had been cutting virtues of people in my town. And that was the end of their problems, of those attacking us. I pray for someone. All your benefits inside any wicked tree in your town and village, villages. Let the Lord recover for you.
Amen.
Recover.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Sit down. Let me give you illustrations very well. When we went to Umbri, how many of you were there? We're about entering our vehicle. I heard the voice of God. Look at the bush. Count four trees. I counted. I took permission from the king of that place. The Lord said we should surrender that tree, that particular tree. We surrendered the tree, prayed with Psalm 29, blew the shofar. The picture is in the office. 5 days after, 12 noon, thunder came from the throne of grace, shattered the tree to pieces. A big pot came out containing the names of sons and daughters home and abroad. And 5 snakes came out. They said the tree had been troubling them for 75 years. Today, any ancient tree anywhere troubling your destiny, that tree shall catch fire.
Amen.
I didn't hear your amen in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let it catch fire. Catch fire. Catch fire. Catch fire.
Catch fire. Catch fire. Catch fire. Catch fire. Catch fire. Catch fire. Catch fire. Catch fire.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Sit down. I'm going somewhere. We were praying here a few years ago. And the Lord said to me, that Psalm 29, that the voice of the Lord is full of power and majesty. The voice of the Lord breaketh the cedar, even the cedar in Lebanon. And the Lord said to me, that cedar in Lebanon is so big that the same voice of the Lord can break every evil tree. I'm looking for the verse. Verse what? Okay, Psalm 29. Okay, let's look at verse 5. The voice of the Lord breaketh the cedar. Yet the Lord breaketh the cedar in... the voice of the Lord makes the hint to carve. Now, that cedar tree is so big that you can make a highway through it and it will stand. So, meaning that as we are here, wherever you may be, you can release the voice of the Lord to go and attack any ancient tree.
Yes,
that
sir.
Is it. And that will be the end. When I told them in the prayer meeting that pray all my benefits inside any tree, Lord, bring them out and set that tree on fire. We use Matthew 3:10. Now the axe is laid upon the root of any tree that does not bear fruit, it shall be hewn down and cast into the fire. We use Matthew 3:10. Every tree that my heavenly Father has not planted shall be rooted out. And I ask people to pray. Matthew 15:13. Every evil tree in my hometown, in the palace, waging war against me, my brothers, my sisters, the one that has swallowed our benefits, be on fire in the name of God. Right inside here, God opened the eyes of evangelist Ukaigbu. He saw the tree at the center of the town and a door, and he saw gold, money coming out of it, and he started packing. Any tree that has swallowed your benefits shall vomit them in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You didn't say amen.
Amen.
Shall vomit them. 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 In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Sit down. This is very deep. That's why I have shown you the one that happened live and direct. Wherever you may be, I want you to send the voice of the Lord to go and attack any tree attacking your destiny. Are you ready? To go and attack any tree that has swallowed your benefits, your recovery that you should be using. And when you pray that prayer very well, come and see what will happen. Are you ready now? Jump up on your feet. If you know that in your own family, nobody does well to a level required, because there is a particular tree they are worshiping, come out. They say, until you venerate the dead by a tree, you can't make it. Please, just come out. There is a particular tree that when they give birth to any baby in your family, they must take the baby there. Who is that person? Raise up your hand. Okay. Today is your day. You see the way you are, you look beautiful, but the background, you go. No, all these things, they are practical. And I tell pastors, if you don't have this grace, don't condemn it. Don't condemn what you don't know.
Yes, sir.
Stay in the area of your motivation. God will help you there. Amen. I enjoy it. I love it. But leave me in the area of this Korokoro Adura. Virtually everybody has a prayer ministry where he or she goes these days.
Yes,
oh, but 4 years, you know, I draw 1 4 year, 1 5 1 3. The first one is this. Any evil tree challenging my progress, you command that tree to die by what?
Fire.
Instant. Are you ready now? Now, everybody, you will shout 7 Holy Ghost fire. Where to go?
Holy Ghost fire. Uh-huh. Holy Ghost fire. 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 Holy Ghost fire.
Now shout the blood of Jesus.
The blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus.
Please, who is this person? They said, for you to make progress, they took you to one tree where they tied a red cloth and a white one, and they now put something like a nail, nail it to the place. Who is that person? Raise up your hand. Come here. Bring her. Isaiah 22:25. That thing they nailed there, they nail your progress. But look at the Bible. And it shall come to pass today, says the Lord, that the nail, isho, abeli, or peg, that is fastened in the short place shall be removed today.
Amen.
Shaminada.
Amen.
If they nail your progress, they nail your pregnancy, they nail your visa, if they nail your money, you better say amen. The nail shall be removed today.
Amen.
Shaminada.
Amen.
It shall be removed.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Put that scripture there. Today is today. It's a restoration. You think that's small thing? It shall come to pass today that the nail, another version says the peg, that is fastened in the sure place, be removed and be cut down.
Amen.
And it will fall.
Amen.
That's why the tree must fall.
Amen.
And the burden that was upon it shall be cut off, for the Lord has spoken.
Amen.
I'm seeing about 7 sisters. They said you were Ogbanje. They actually took you there and put sacrifice by a tree. I want them to walk to the front here, one by one. Oh yeah, in the name of Jesus. Come. Number 1. Yes, number 2. Yes, number 3. Number 4. Today is today.
Yes, Lord.
Na, ta, 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 ta. That is it. Baba Okaigbo brought a man who had been trying to go abroad to me. And I was praying for that general. I said, excuse me, sir. There is this thing by your church. I described the tree. I said, that's the tree worrying you. The man just collapsed. And I asked him to pray the prayer. We want to pray. He prayed. The thing dried up within 3 days. Then it's all over the world now. Are you ready now?
Yes,
everybody shout Holy Ghost fire 7 times.
Holy Ghost fire.
Uh-huh.
Holy Ghost fire.
Louder.
Holy Ghost fire.
Shout it.
Holy Ghost fire.
Shout it.
Holy Ghost fire.
Uh-huh.
Holy Ghost fire.
Uh-huh.
Holy Ghost fire.
Uh-huh.
Holy Ghost fire.
Uh-huh.
Holy Ghost fire. Uh-huh. Holy Ghost fire.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Pastor, the Lord said he wants to give restoration.
Amen.
Recovery.
Amen. Amen.
Repositioning.
Amen. Amen.
Tremendous one. Eh? And restoration. And reward.
Reward. Amen.
So why don't you, from here, from this altar, send the voice of the Lord to go and dry up that tree? Whether the tree is inside the water or on the land, there's no barrier in the realm of this thing. You are just free. Amen. Are you ready now? Everybody say after me, any evil tree,
any evil tree,
waging war against my destiny,
waging war against my destiny.
Can you shout it one more time?
Any evil tree, waging war against my destiny.
Your time is up.
Your time is up.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Bomb by fire.
Bomb by fire. Bomb by fire. Bomb by fire. Bomb by fire. Bomb by fire. Bomb by fire. Bomb by fire. Bomb by fire. Bomb by fire.
Bomb
by fire. Bomb by fire. Bomb by fire. Bomb by fire.
Holy Ghost. He's burning! He's burning! Palaces, pray this one more than anybody. Say, any strange tree,
any strange tree,
Iwoigi Abami, holding me and my progress,
holding me and my progress,
so mumi atire mi male. Hear the voice of the Lord,
hear the voice of the Lord,
bahu oluwa lorun alaye. In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Ni oruko Jesu.
Ni oruko Jesu.
Release me, let me go.
Release me, let me go.
To mi si le je ki ma lo. Then I want to be any release me, let me go. See what will happen. Say any strange tree.
Any strange tree.
Holding me and my progress down.
Holding me and my progress down.
Oh, the Lord is telling me that 1,000 people will receive immediate deliverance.
Amen.
Say, hear the voice of the Lord.
Hear the voice of the Lord.
By fire, by force.
By fire, by force.
By fire, by thunder.
By fire, by thunder.
It is time for me to progress.
It is time for me to progress.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
As I'm clapping.
As I'm clapping.
Release me, let me go.
Release me, let me go. Release me, let me go. Release me, let me go. Release me, let me go. Release me, let me go. Release me, let me go. Release me, let me go. Release me.
I wish you could shout very well.
Let me go. Release me.
Oh yes. Oh yes. Oh yes. Oh yes. Oh yes. Put him on fire. Aha. Today, today. Look at us. This idea. Something is happening to you. I love the way you are praying. Pray more. Pray more. Aha. Let me go. Let me go. Let me go. Let me go.
Let me go. Let me go. Let me go.
Let me go.
Let me go.
This is the
shout. This is the time to shout. Let me go. 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 Shout it more than anybody here.
Voice of the Lord.
Shout it one more time.
Voice of the Lord.
Arise.
Arise.
Go to my native town.
Go to my native town.
Go to my place of birth.
Go to my place of birth.
Attack every strange tree.
Attack every strange tree.
Affecting my destiny.
Affecting my destiny.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Say all the strange trees.
All the strange trees.
In my place of birth.
In my place of birth.
In my native town.
In my native town.
In my village.
In my village.
Affecting my destiny.
Affecting my destiny.
Hear the word of the Lord.
Hear the word of the Lord.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Voice of the Lord.
Voice of the Lord.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Attack them. Attack them. Attack them. Attack them.
Attack them. Attack them.
Voice of the Lord.
Attack them.
Voice of the Lord.
Voice of God.
Oh, Oluwa.
Voice of God. Attack them. 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 Voice of God. Attack them.
Jesus, say we pray.
Amen.
One hand on your head. One hand on your head. Any sacrifice they have done to any tree, whether by a sea, the one they have done in the coven, the one they have done to the tree at the center of the town, the one they have done to any tree in your yard, any sacrifice they have done, any appeasement, what they have done when you were born and you were named by that tree, what they did when you married into that family and they took you to that tree, what they did against your business and your life by that tree, any sacrifice they have done, because of the sacrifice that Jesus was made for us by shedding his blood on Calvary,
yes,
with a very loud amen, let that sacrifice of Jesus on the cross of Calvary cancel that sacrifice.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Cancel it now.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let the power in the blood of Jesus cancel every effect of that sacrifice by that tree upon your life, upon your progress, upon your marriage, upon your finances. If you can say the loudest amen. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
If there is anything they have nailed to any tree to stop you from progressing, to nail you from getting married, to nail you from having money, to nail you from doing well in life, to nail you from getting your visa, to nail you from progressing in life, that strange nail, according to Isaiah 20:25, if your amen is the loudest, let the Lord remove it in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let it be removed now.
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 Amen.
Let it be removed. 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 Release your two hands. Now, please, ladies and gentlemen, everybody, you must pray this prayer very well. We want to recover our benefits kept in the water, in the marine kingdom.
Yes, sir.
In any coven, in any witchcraft coven. Please, I want everybody to shout. Say, where is the Lord God of Elijah?
Where is the Lord God of Elijah?
Arise!
Arise!
Help me to
recover.
Help me to recover.
Say all my benefits.
All my benefits.
All my breakthrough.
All my breakthrough.
Kept in the Mary Kingdom.
Kept in the Mary Kingdom.
In any altar.
In any altar.
In any coven.
In any coven.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
As I clap my hands.
As I clap my hands.
I recover. I recover. I recover.
I recover. I recover. I recover.
I recover. Those of you kneeling down, stand up on your feet. Everybody, now listen to me. The earth is the Lord and the fullness thereof. The one that did that then. What I did that for, he has founded upon the waters and established upon the seas. God owns the marine. Everybody, I want us to fight. Use your own mouth to say, oh, ye marine kingdom!
Oh, ye marine kingdom!
Hear the voice of the Lord!
Hear the voice of the Lord!
In the name of Jesus!
In the name of Jesus!
Say, oh, ye altars!
Oh, ye altars!
Oh, ye covens!
Oh, ye covens!
Hear the voice of the Lord!
Hear the voice of the Lord!
In the name of Jesus!
In the name of Jesus!
It is time!
It is time!
For me and my family!
For me and my family!
To recover!
To recover!
Our benefits!
Our benefits!
Our breakthroughs
that have been kept
inside of you. So
in the name of Jesus,
by fire by thunder,
all our benefits
in the marine kingdom,
in any coven,
in the name of Jesus.
I recover.
If you love your destinies, those of you from polygamous family, those of you from wicked villages and towns, those of you from the palaces, please pray this prayer very well. Say, all my breakthroughs!
All my breakthroughs!
I want to hear that voice. Say, all my benefits! That had been stolen and kept in the polygamous house. All my benefits that have been stolen and kept in the village, in my hometown. All my benefits that have been stolen and kept in any palace. Hear the word of the Lord. In the name of Jesus, as I'm shouting, be restored in Jesus' name.
Be restored in Jesus' name. Be restored in Jesus' name. Be restored in Jesus' name. Be restored in Jesus' name.
You better shout.
Be restored in Jesus' name.
Be restored in Jesus' name.
Be restored in Jesus' name. Be restored in Jesus' name. Be restored in Jesus' name.
Restoration prayer.
Be restored in Jesus' name. Be restored in Jesus' name.
Be restored. Be restored. Be restored. Be restored in Jesus' name. Be restored in Jesus' name.
Be restored in Jesus' name.
This is wonderful. Shout more, shout more, shout more, shout more. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Say, my keys of breakthrough.
My keys of breakthrough.
Kokora la jami. Oya bedangli ki. Say, my keys of breakthrough.
My keys of breakthrough.
That have been stolen.
That have been stolen.
Hear the word of the Lord.
Hear the word of the Lord.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
You will shout, I recover in Jesus' name 3 times. Say, I recover in Jesus' name.
I recover in Jesus' name.
Louder.
I recover in Jesus' name.
Louder.
I recover in Jesus' name.
Say a big amen.
Amen.
Then all firstborn benefits. Whether you are firstborn or not, you better say, my firstborn benefits.
My firstborn benefits.
If you are the only girl in the family, you are the firstborn girl. If you are the only one, you better shout. And you have firstborn male, say, all my firstborn benefits.
All my firstborn benefits.
Say, where are you?
Where are you?
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Appear, 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 appear.
Appear,
oh yeah,
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 appear,
oh yeah, come to the last stage of this part one. Please, this is the time for every believer to really stand on the authority of our new birth to have the anointing for recovery. The first one. Anointing for total recovery.
Anointing for total recovery.
I want the sisters to say it alone.
And
was that the loudest you could shout? How about the brothers? Everybody together.
Anointing for total recovery.
Say, I am available.
I am available.
With my family members.
With my family members.
Say, my work is available.
My work is available.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Touch your head. Release the two hands again. Everybody, I want you to say this with anger. Anointing for total restoration.
Anointing for total restoration.
Anointing for total reward.
Anointing for total reward.
Anointing for repositioning.
Anointing for repositioning.
I am available.
I am available.
With my family members.
With my family members.
And my world.
And my world.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Then we pray.
Amen.
He suffers no man to do us any wrong. He rebukes the kings for our sake, saying, touch not my anointed and do my prophets no harm. Any power that may want to challenge us after this meeting, let that power die.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
No regrouping.
Amen.
No backlashing.
Amen.
No repositioning.
Amen.
In the kingdom of darkness.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Any tragedy for change against me and my family.
Backfire
in Jesus' name.
Backfire
in Jesus' name.
Backfire
in Jesus' name.
Backfire
in Jesus' name.
Backfire
any tragedy fashion against us and our family.
Backfire
any tragedy fashion against us and our family.
Backfire
in Jesus' name.
Backfire
in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name.
Backfire.
Backfire. Begin to enjoy those benefits that we have recovered in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Go back to your seat. The Lord said to me that he wants to release a healing grace. But let me give this testimony. Last week, when I was on vacation, Tuesday evening, I was meditating. The Lord said to me, son, go and peel the healing from sicknesses, the book God has written to my hand, and begin to prophesy the word upon those who will come for Wednesday service. So I called my PA, he gave me a copy, I started ministering to every one of you. On Wednesday, when my son, Reverend Tunji Adepoju, came here, that was the first thing he said. And I thank God for his sensitivity in the realm of the spirit. The Lord said to me this morning again that he said, I want to release healing grace. And then he said, tell the people I want to take away, completely take away, amen, stubborn sicknesses.
Amen.
Exodus 23:25. And ye shall serve the Lord your God, and he shall bless your bread and thy water, and I will take sicknesses away. God, when God says he wants to take something away, that's it. He wants to take the sickness away. Let this logo become a rema. He wants to take it away from your husband, from your wife, from your children, from you, from your me, that it will not come near you again. So this is a takeaway healing grace. God wants to take the thing away, the stubborn sickness that you will never see. Strange sicknesses, God wants to take them away. And so, wherever you may be, just rise up on your feet. If you know you want God to take away any strange sickness from you, and we quickly sing this song, then we move in. Are you ready now? Holy Ghost, deliver me by fire. Are you ready now? Now put down the papers in your hand. Don't write. Face someone. Tutu, quickly. Tutu. Face yourself, tutu. I call you, sir. Imagine. Jaw. Enter, call you, see that person you are facing. If it's nothing, leave that person. Holy Ghost, deliver me by fire.
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 Deliver me by fire. Another person, please make sure you clap louder than that person. Hear me by fire, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus.
Hear me by fire, oh Lord,
in the name of Jesus.
Hear me by fire, oh Lord,
in the name of Jesus.
Hear me by fire, oh Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Face the altar. Now, we have five prayers. You pray one, I prophesy the remaining. Now, say after me.
Any strange sickness.
In my body. In the body of my wife.
In the body of my wife.
In the body of any member of my family.
In the body of any member of my family.
Divine medication.
Divine medication.
Blood of Jesus.
Blood of Jesus.
Flush it out. In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Then you'll be saying, blood of Jesus, flush it out. Blood of Jesus. Are you ready now? Say, any strange sickness.
Any strange sickness in my body.
In my body. Define medication. In the name of Jesus.
Blood of Jesus, flush it out.
Blood of Jesus, flush it out.
Blood of Jesus, flush it out. Blood of Jesus, flush it out.
In Jesus, then we pray.
Amen.
One hand on your head, one on your belly button. Kalibori Gazantalia. I make a decree in the name of Jesus that strange sickness in your body, in the body of your spouse or your children, let the blood of Jesus flush it out in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Get ready where you are. There is an operation that will take place now. Get ready. Every bullet of darkness, bullet of cancer, tumor. Every bullet of darkness moving about in your body. Now get ready. Every arrow of sickness in your body, in the name of Jesus, let that thing dry up in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Yes, let it drive. Look at that woman there. Something is happening. Oh yes, that's it. Oh yes. Come on. Of sickness in you, I bind it and cast it away in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Lastly, everybody say after me, immediate healing grace.
Immediate healing grace.
Say it again.
Immediate healing grace.
Healing grace. Ozubo. Now. Say immediate healing grace.
Immediate healing grace.
Flow into my body. In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Flow. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
From the crown of your head to the sole of your feet. From the crown of the head of your spouse or any child in that family to the soul of the thing. Even from the crown of the head of that person lying down at the verge of death. Here it is. He was wounded for your transgression, bruised for your iniquities. The chastisement of your peace has been upon him, by strength you have been made whole. Now, if the spirit of him who raised Jesus Christ of Nazareth from the dead, Romans 8:11, dwelleth in you. He who raised Jesus Christ of Nazareth from the dead will quicken your mortal body because of his spirit that dwelleth in you. From the crown of your head to the soul of your through every organ in your body. Everybody, I want a very loud amen. Instant, immediate, ozubo, healing grace. Receive in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Receive in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
the name of God the Father,
amen.
The Son,
amen.
And the Holy Ghost,
amen.
It is done.
Amen.
Jesus' name, we are healed.
Amen. In Jesus' name.
One loud hallelujah to the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Clap for Jesus and be seated. Thank you. Every Wednesday at the closing, I want to be praying on our projects. Whatever your projects for the year, you must bring it. Lift it up. Oh yeah, lift it up. And don't still forget, you can bring your passport, but genuine one. No fake document. Every project we want God to honor this year, even as we lift them by faith, let the Lord release his empowerment in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let the Lord bless your water.
Amen.
Bless your oil.
Amen.
Bless your prayer request.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ,
Amen.
The love of God,
Amen.
And the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit,
Amen.
Be with us now,
Amen.
And forevermore.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Say, this is my year.
This is my year
of absolute possibilities.
Of absolute possibilities.
I can do all things.
I can do all
through
things.
Christ, who strengthens me.
Strengthens
go
me.
And do well.
Amen.
Jesus' name.
Amen.
I love you with the love of God. Thank you.
You have just listened to this message from the senior pastor of Christ Living Spring Apostolic Ministry, CLAM, Pastor Wole Oladinyo. To order a copy of our video and audio messages, please call 01-794-9712, 0807-658-1733, or visit CLAM Bookshop at Plot 126 CLAM Avenue, Omole, Ikeja. You can also visit our website at www.clamgo.org or join Pastor Wole Oladinyo for the live streaming of our services on www.clamgo.tv. For counseling and prayers, please call 0802-121-4355, 0803-826-6330. And 0805-564-2735. Join us for our Wednesday Revival Hour from 7 a.m. to 10 a.m. every Wednesday, and Sunday Glorious Service from 7 a.m. to 10 a.m. As you come, you'll be blessed in Jesus' name. Amen. 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 In Jesus' name. Settled.